When Connie and I were stranded on the jungle moon, we saw something. A vision.
Watch the weight of the crystal gems, rose quartz, shatter, pink diamond.
¿Por qué no puedes contármelo?
Quería decírtelo desde hace tiempo.
Time for answers. New episodes of Steven Universe, only on Cartoon Network.
Welcome back to Crystal Clear on the Roundtable. I'm Ashrek Vox, and Latin America has aired yet another promo for Steven Universe, this one running 30 seconds, and it features some more new footage from the upcoming May special, Can't Go Back and A Single Pale Rose. So really quickly, I want to run through these scenes, analyze, break down what's in them, what's happening, and then turn the table to you guys. Alright, let's dive in. First things first, I just really want to appreciate that both these episodes are animated by Sunmin. For those of you unaware, Steven Universe is animated by two studios. Sunmin and Rough Draft. Sunmin has produced some of the series' best episodes, and they look great. While Rough Draft's episodes tend to have thinner lines, they're more prone to being off-model, it's not a good time. That's a discussion for an entirely separate occasion. But these two episodes being Sunmin explains why both Pool Hopping and Letters to Lars were both animated by Rough Draft. The Critiverse knew these are two huge episodes, so they handed them off to the best of the best. Our first new glimpse of footage is a shot of Steven talking to Pearl, appearing very distraught, upset, asking, "Why can't you tell me?" as we shift to the familiar angle of Pearl covering her mouth. Again, the popular theory is that Pearl physically can't tell Steven what happened. And the likely culprit for this is White Diamond, that White Diamond with her hypothetical mind powers put a seal on Pearl, preventing her from speaking about Homeworld's truths. What happened to Pink Diamond? What Pearl knows about Homeworld's hierarchy. We believe that within Pearl are secrets unknown. But I want to make a proposition. While there's less of a compelling case for this, what if the suspect who put Pearl under this seal was none other than Rose Quartz herself? That whatever involvement Pearl had with Pink's shattering, Rose wanted to never get out. All the traumatic things Pearl had seen throughout the years serving Homeworld, Rose wanted her to never spill, to never relive that trauma. That Rose wanted to minimize the risk of Pearl being a target, or even having Garnet, Bismuth, and the other crystal gems turn against Pearl. I know Bismuth was likely bubbled when Pink Diamond was shattered, but ultimately, some way somehow, Rose did something that prevents Pearl from ever speaking the truth. Hey, Steven has mind powers, he can go inside the mind. So that's not out of the realm of possibility. And just like how Rose put a lock on Pearl, Steven can remove the lock. It would explain some inconsistencies in the White Diamond theory. Like, why would White Diamond have control over Pearl, put a seal on her, but not shatter her? And it would continue to portray Rose in this moral gray light. In a way, it can be viewed as protecting Pearl, but on the other hand, it can just be seen as protecting herself, covering her own tracks. Now, the synopsis for A Single Pale Rose is simply, Steven helps Pearl look for her cell phone. Yeah, it's one of those episodes. Give us a really vague synopsis that only has a little bit to do with the episode. But this has led to speculation that perhaps Steven and Pearl will communicate through texting, something Rose or White Diamond or whoever couldn't account for because that technology did not exist at the time, allowing Pearl to text Steven the truth.
Maybe illustrated in little emojis. That'd be cool, right?
But honestly, I prefer the angle of a Gemwar flashback, Steven falling asleep and living that flashback over anything else, because the texting thing can be kind of corny and it would date the show in the future. And our next shot of new footage is Steven walking up a staircase into a clouded area. Literally, the walls are clouds. However, when we pair this up with previous footage, things tend to make a lot more sense. Originally, I speculated when Steven walks into the moon base, he's looking up at a mural of White Diamond. And while that still may be possible, now I'm inclined to believe Steven walks into the moon base only to hear a sound in the distance. What he's looking up at is the room with the moon orb, which leads to this shot here. And the clouds, the lighting of the scene, matches up with the previous promo and the shots of Garnet, Amethyst, and Pearl fighting something. Again, I believe they could be sparring. Maybe it's a corrupted gem. But if anything, I think this solidifies Lapis's watching the gems from Earth. But again, that means whatever is happening here, with Garnet's rocket launchers, Amethyst's whips, Pearl's spear, isn't some big action set piece, especially for witnessing it through the lens of Lapis and Steven. Because that means we know everything will be okay by the next episode. So yes, unfortunately, we still may not be getting the White Diamond information we wanted, but we're closer to the truth. Information on White Diamond will follow. It just may be more closer to this season than we would like. But that's about everything. As always, what do you guys think? Did Rose put the seal on Pearl? What do you think is going on in the Moon Orb Room? Let us know in the comments below, or tweet those thoughts really to me at AstrakVox, or at the Roundtable on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all at RoundtableVids. Or you can let us know on Stardust. Follow us at RoundtableVids and tag us in your Steven Universe reactions. Try to tag your reaction, your theory, with the correlating episode, like all these wonderful people.
Steven Universe, a lot of the maps that are shown in the show are missing Russia, but one of the maps has key points of interest for the gems, and one of them's in the middle of the ocean where Russia used to be. In the newest episode, Your Mother and Mine, the diamonds try to blow up the crystal gems, so maybe that is why Russia's missing. The diamonds blew it up.
I was just rewatching Together Breakfast, and there's a moment when Steven is sliding down the crystal heart that you can see the background change. It looks like Rose's room. It's the only moment where he's not screaming. He actually says, this is actually not that bad. But once he leaves the room, he actually starts screaming again. This is the first time we see Rose's room without realizing it. And it's a nice little nod that Steven is comfortable in Rose's room and actually knows that he's supposed to be there.
Rose Quartz reminds me a lot about this character Knights from Sega. They're both carefree characters who wants nothing but freedom and use other characters to benefit and keep their freedom, either by using their powers to make them stronger or having them join their war so they can keep their freedom. Even after years, they're still using other people for the experience for their freedom.
Here's a fun theory about a season later. Okay, what if it was one of those bubble rose quartzes that shattered Pink Diamond? They all blamed it on our Rose because she's the one who started the dang rebellion. And, she didn't want to talk about it in front of the gems, and the gems thought it was her anyway. Like, maybe Eyeball actually saw that Rose. Like, our Rose wasn't even around.
Okay, I found something crazy. I know how humans and gems can fuse together. It all wraps around Steven. So, Steven and Connie fuse together. This is an example. They fuse together, and then they also fuse with Peridot. And then after that, Steven leaves the fusion, and then Connie and Peridot are there together.
Again, link in the description, our username is RoundtableVids. It's a good way to interact with all of you. If you want to help us grow, subscribe to the Roundtable on Patreon. Get exclusive perks like access to our avatars, our scripts, exclusive behind-the-scenes updates, and so much more. You can even have your name featured at the end of the video like all these beautiful, wonderful people. Link in the description. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, share, and if you're new here, subscribe. Hit that bell for notifications to stay in the loop with all things Steven. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have an awesome day. Ostrich Vox, out.